This is an update regarding an Instagram login issue where two-factor authentication is required to log in, prompting a software update to a newer version that supports two-factor login. As I mentioned earlier, this mostly affects users who have upgraded to newer devices, performed a factory reset, or simply enabled two-factor authentication and then tried to log in shortly after. Additionally, even though it prompts for a software update, access still remains limited whether the software is already up to date or doesn't need an update at all. Since we are still exploring more workaround solutions, along with what I shared in my previous video, here is another way you can successfully log into your account without getting blocked by this message. But before we start, if you are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that I will keep you updated on new solutions and changes. Now, for verified accounts, the solution I'm about to show might still be a bit tricky due to the advanced protection features, but it's worth trying as I continue searching for more solutions. So first, open your Play Store and search for Instagram Lite. In case you don't have access to Instagram Lite, then you can download it via a trusted browser. After installing, open it, and this is where you need to pay close attention. As you know, Instagram Lite is just a lighter version of the official Instagram app. Because of that, it uses browser mechanics to bypass initial login prompts and can save devices as trusted, which may make it easier to log into the official app later on. Now on the login page, enter your username or email as usual, then your password, and log in. Since you have set up two-factor authentication before, enter the code from your authentication app or SMS. Now before logging in, make sure to select Trust this device because this step is more important. Once you are logged in, then now you can return to the official Instagram app, enter your login details, and because you trusted the device, you won't need to enter any security code to log in, and therefore you should be able to log into your account successfully without getting through the other restriction. If this method doesn't work, another option is to log in via browser, disable two-factor authentication there, and you can then log into the app. For a detailed procedure on how to do that, you can check out my other video at the end screen or the link in the pinned comment, but I'll keep you updated, so be sure to subscribe.